So let's talk about a new kind of supply chain attack. This one is different because it goes after trust itself. The goal here isn't to make a lot of noise or break things, it's about silent theft. And what's the prize? Well, it's the keys to the kingdom, the credentials that unlock your most critical systems. We're talking your build, your cloud, and your software release pipelines. Now, this attack didn't just pop up overnight, it's been evolving. You see, version 1 was all about getting a quiet foothold, just sneaking into trusted software packages. Then version 2, that's when they scaled things up, really aggressively. But version 3, this is where things get really interesting. It's a huge shift. This latest wave is all about refinement. It's designed to be much quieter, to run more reliably, and to patiently turn those stolen secrets into long-term, persistent access right across your entire network. So to be clear, version 3 isn't some brand new attack, it's just smarter. It's built to last, to achieve long-term persistence. So how does it do that? Well, it changes its identifiers to evade detection, it gets rid of all the noisy, destructive code that might raise alarms, and it's been improved to be more stable, so it works reliably on more systems. The goal here is really simple, just stay hidden for as long as possible.
Okay, so why should this be on every leader's radar? Right? It's because this isn't really about one single infected package. This is about the trust boundaries of your entire organization completely collapsing. Think about it. When a developer's machine or one of your build systems leaks credentials, the attackers don't have to break down the door. They can just walk right in. They can use your own trusted accounts and your own delivery channels to push their malicious code. It basically becomes an attack from the inside, using your own keys to the castle.
Look, you don't need 100% certainty here to start taking action. You can start by asking your teams a few very direct questions. The big one is, did a risky package ever run in a privileged environment? We're talking about a build server or maybe a developer's laptop. If the answer is yes, or even maybe, you have to assume those credentials are at risk. From there, the only path forward is to dig in and verify everything aggressively and immediately.
All right, so what's the game plan? It's pretty clear. Contain, prevent, and detect. First up, contain the immediate threat. That means rotating any exposed credentials and auditing all the access events. Next, you prevent future issues. This is where you harden your defenses and really lock down your dependencies. And finally, you have to detect these kinds of threats. And the best way to do that is to start treating your release pipeline like the critical production system it is, because you can bet the attackers already do. And that really leaves us with one crucial question. Are you monitoring the pathways the attackers value most just as closely as you're watching your front door?